used for? What is a Venn diagram used for? Anyone have an idea? Yeah, your hand went up. Sounds good. So there's two things here. One is FLA and the other is SLA. Kind of want to double check this. What do you think SLA means?
Language acquisition.
I want to double check. What do you think FLA means?
First language acquisition.
There it is. In my head, it meant foreign language, but that's much better. So, thank you. It means foreign language. So, sorry, first. So maybe you can just label your diagram. On this side, on your blank sheet of paper. Let's make a Venn diagram, and FLA, first language, let's name it so we know, because I actually didn't know. Other side, SLA, middle both. I need three volunteers. You don't know what you're gonna do. I just need three people to come sit. Bring your chair forward. One. Come, bring yourself forward with your chair. Bring your chair.
Which chair?
Unless you want to stand up, it's fine.
Okay,
Nader. Okay, Nader Beck, you want to be the third one?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right. You will be Miss FLA. Nader Beck will be Mr. Bo. Come in the middle. Rubahar will be Miss SLA. Yeah, you need your chair. No.
You will stay at Miss FLA.
You're Miss FLA. Okay? Now, these individuals are representing three different, I guess we could say, what is about characteristics of second language acquisition, what is about first language acquisition, and the middle is both. Very quickly, before I begin, what were your first words in Uzbek or Russian? Can someone tell me what were they?
Dada,
mama, okay? Very good. Next, how long did it take before you could put two or three words together? How long?
1-2 years.
2 or 3 years. 2 or 3 years.
No, 1 or 3 years.
6 months. Different, I think 6 months is good time.
That's too early.
My daughter is not speaking now.
Okay. Next question. How long did it take? You're going to show me on your hand this time. This is why we did it. Show me on your hand how many years did it take before you think a child could make sentences. I'm seeing four, not with your mouth. I'm seeing four, I'm seeing three, I'm seeing two. You can also participate. Three, okay, one, okay, according to her. Now, did you have explicit, meaning someone teaching you the grammar, Chaudhu, over here, of your language?
No,
right?
No.
Okay, beautiful. Did they have, okay, so no one had, as a baby, no one came and taught you this, you know, bold after, you know, min, and then, no. So, now talking about second language learning, there's some differences, right?
Yeah.
What do you think, and people can just share quickly, a difference maybe between learning a first language and a second? Does anyone have an idea? What are some differences? You just want to raise your hand and share. I'm curious. Yes, please, with your mask.
In the first language, we spend much more time speaking the language, communicating.
Okay.
In the second language, we just spend some period of time.
Okay. Someone else? Less time?
Limited.
Less input?
In the first, learners can learn
but
okay.
Partners and like a behavior theory, they repeating the words from their parents or their family members. In the second language, in the first implicitly, in the second explicitly, by someone.
Got it. I'm going to just add, in the first, you have so much input.
Yeah.
Yes. Right?
Yeah.
Okay, you want to say something else?
We learn first language by our needs, because we need water, we need something to
toilet,
eat.
Food.
We learn our first language, and we learn second language for with the help of our interest.
Okay.
Maybe we're interested in learning English, that's why we learned English.
Okay. Yeah, I like that. No one told you learn your first language.
Yeah.
It just happened.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Naturally. Okay. Thank you. We're going to go in a moment to these individuals. I just wanted to do these quick discussion points. So most people have explicit instruction when learning a second language, right?
Yeah.
Most people. So now we're going to make a diagram, and these individuals are going to read the ways that they are similar.
Mm-hmm.
That will be Naderbeck. And then first language acquisition will be Gulbaha. She's going to, Gulbaha, right?
Yeah.
Yes. Gulbaha, all right, got it. She's going to say it, you're going to fill it in.
Mm-hmm.
And she'll only read it twice.
Mm-hmm.
So you can stand.
FLA, yes.
FLA, first language acquisition. I hope you have your chart. I don't see a chart there, huh? You need to create your charts. Okay, but try to make it look like that.
Yes, SLAs and booths.
Yeah, pop. You do how you want. However you want, man.
Yes.
All right, you don't have to do it this way, but I'm showing you the Venn diagram. Go ahead.
FLA or SLA?
FLA.
First language.
First language.
Yes, first language.
Parisi?
Yes.
Little or no explicit instruction. Many years listening
to or more.
Please don't interrupt. Let her speak. Just listen.
Using sounds and single words before forming sentences.
Try your best. She's just reading it. Just try your best. Okay?
Modified input. No conscious effort required. Vocabulary and concepts acquired simultaneously.
You're going to read it one more time slower. You're doing great. One more time. Slower.
Little or no explicit instruction.
Okay, take a breath. Take two breaths. Take two breaths.
Little or no explicit instruction.
Our manual instructions are improving.
Many years listening, babbling, using sounds and single words before forming sentences.
Are you in a hurry?
She doesn't
breathe.
Many years listening, babbling, using sounds and single words before forming sentences. Next one, modified input. No conscious effort required. No conscious effort required. Effort required. Last one, vocabulary and concepts acquired simultaneously. Vocabulary and concepts acquired simultaneously.
Thank you. Let's clap for her. Nice job. All right, give them 5 seconds and then you can start. 5 seconds.
5 seconds.
Wait.
SLA.
Almost. Almost, always, explicit instruction.
Beautiful.
Learning is faster, especially
older?
Older learners.
Enough. She did what? Great. Great job. Give them 5 seconds. Don't talk with anyone yet.
Can I stay in the middle?
Go in the middle. All right. He's doing for both now.
First one. Predictable stages. Use context and interaction to understand. Next, comprehension. Before vocalization. Vocalization. Interaction is essential.
It's good. Let me get it back. All right. Nice job, everyone. We're going to do an activity with it in a moment. Let me just add a couple of points. If you have space in your circles, feel free to add some of these. if you feel that it's relative. So L1 is which side?
This one.
FLA.
FLA. First language.
L2, which side?
This one.
Beautiful. So I guess there's five main differences. Neurological, right? How their brains are developing. Cognitive, how their thinking is. Affective, emotions. Linguistic, right? How they're developing language skills and their context, I guess, where they are. So here are some examples of these differences explained. This is all relevant to you because you teach which of these are you teachers of? You're a second language acquisition teacher, so you should know about the theory, right? So let's check it out. Basically, adults is which side? Can someone tell me?
Adults.
Maybe both.
If you think it's this side, point here. If you think it's this side, point here. Where is adults?
Here.
Here. SLA. SLA. Where are children? Yeah, so in general, children are over here.
Yeah.
Adults are over there. All right, cool. So here it's saying adults have greater muscular coordination, right? Their bodies, they can move them better. You may want to add that there. Children have greater flexibility. I don't think it means physical flexibility. They may also do yoga or something, but I think it means their brains are growing, right? So you may want to add that in your circles. You may want to write on the FLA side, children, brain flexible. So as I'm doing this, you keep filling in the two sides. Second one, cognitive differences. What does cognitive mean, anyone?
It's mental.
Mental. Can you not see this? Maybe we can move this over. Mental, thinking, understanding. Okay, good. Just for the others. Children develop language and cognition at the same time. They learn vocabulary and
concepts
at the same time. Now, adults already understand concepts, right? You already know what apple is, like her example. Almas, right? Almas?
Almas.
Okay, yabla, I got it, I'm so happy.
Yabla.
They only, yablaka, they only need to learn the new vocabulary. I'm losing eyes. We lost them. All right, adults have, what do they have? I'm joking.
Abstract response.
Abstract?
Reasoning.
So you could fill that in. If you want to keep filling in, you can. They have the ability to abstract reason. What does effective mean?
Effective.
This one. Not
emotions.
Effective.
Emotions.
Emotions. There's a difference. Adults have
anxieties.
I would also say adolescents do too.
Yeah.
Right? Because adolescents are probably more what?
Anxiety.
They're more second language acquisition. They're not first language. They also have inhibition. What's inhibition mean? Something like
not me.
With hesitation.
With hesitation.
Fear.
Fear. Children.
Don't.
They're free. They're more free. They're more open. No. They're still developing their identity. Okay. These are all inside of your notes as well, if you want to look at them. I just want to go over it. Linguistic differences. Oh, this is a really good point. Adults have meta-linguistic awareness. Does anyone know what meta-linguistic means? It's an interesting topic.
Meta.
Meta.
I think that's a new name for Facebook.
Meta.
Using your language consciously.
Something like that. Meta is your ability to think about what you're thinking. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No.
So right now, I'm thinking about what I want to say next.
Please repeat it tomorrow.
Just let it be.
You're right, it's hard. It's the end of the day.
Yes.
Right now, she's thinking about me repeating it tomorrow in the morning. Right?
This is mental.
That's metalinguistic. Thinking about what's happening inside.
Yeah. Analyzing.
Analyze. Self-reflection.
Yeah.
Children cannot do this. Adults can.
Yes.
This is why sometimes your brain does not stop. Right?
Yeah.
Anyone have that? I have that. It does not stop. Brum, 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 brum. Okay, contextual differences. FLA is?
Always informal.
Informal. It's immersion. You have lots of time. You don't need to communicate. When you're a baby, you just sit there. You just eat. Right? Life is good. When you get old, life gets complicated. There's no one yelling at you to talk, right? You talk at your own time. And modified inputs. I think that means you get different kinds of input. I believe. You hear things, you smell things, you have all the senses, you know? SLA is very
formal.
It's in a classroom. Time, maybe a lot, maybe very little.
Yeah.
Right? Your students, maybe they hear English 2-3 hours a week.
Yeah.
A baby hears English language how much?
All day.
All day, all night. High communicative demand. Right? Your students are learning and they're forced to write and speak right away.
Mm-hmm.
And little modification. Okay. So hopefully you heard something. If you could fill any of these ideas into your chart, I'll just share this. These are the things that are present. What's this? Minus? Plus? We don't know. So this, I think, as well, tomorrow I'm going to be able to understand what's happening here. I think these are the things that are happening in each of these examples. So tomorrow you're going to make presentations about this. In groups, you're gonna present this in like in a what's it called, poster. So I think that we've done enough. Like you were saying, your brains are fried. So we'll just end with this. I'd love for you to grab out your phones, write something, not even two, one activity you learned. And why it is effective to use with adolescents. You don't need to tell me the whole thing. Share one thing. One thing you learned about children and teen development with Tamrika this morning. Anything. One thing. If you learned five, don't write five. Just write one.
Should we write or audio?
I'm not going to force you to do it the way... You may do whatever you want.
All right?
You've got 10 minutes. You can write it. You can audio it. Bless you. Stop pulling. Group chat. Formal group. Let's hear what you learned today. Okay?
Can we do a bit scaffolding about tomorrow's assignment?
The assignment is... In groups, you're going to present all these ideas creatively. That's all it is. You'll get a group grade. No laptop. And I'm going to show you some nice examples from my other class that were very creative and fun.
Assessments? Individually or group?
Group.
Oh, okay.